ओके
वेरी
स्टार्ट
गुड मॉर्निंग टू
करिए।
वन एंड ऑल,
हाय
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू दिस ऑनलाइन क्लास वेयर वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कंपनी एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन। इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव सीन दैट व्हाट अ कंपनी इज, व्हाट आर द की डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन इंडियन कंपनीज एक्ट 1956 and Indian Companies Act 2013. Also, we could learn that company is an artificial juridical person. It is born out of law, functions by the law, and also dies or winded up by the legal provisions. Whenever we set up a house or whenever we build a ship, it will not run automatically. Similarly, an organization after formation will not run automatically. To run the organization here, to run the company, we need the captains. Who will run the company? Also, we have come across two important documents while learning in the last session, that Memorandum of Association, which establishes the relationship between the company and the outsiders, as well as Articles of Association, which gives the bylaws for internal administration or internal management. Again, it gives powers that who will run the company. They are the directors. Combinedly, the directors are known as Board of Directors. It is the board. The all-powerful body of the company is the board of directors, which is consisting of many directors. Here, company in company administration, we will know how the directors are appointed, what are their qualifications, what rights they exercise, what powers they govern, what they should do, what they should not do. While empowerment of women is a big issue now, is there any provision for a woman director? What do we mean by resident director? What are the different types of directors? Shadow director, de facto director, additional director, key managerial personnels. These are the various terms we have to understand while understanding or while learning about company administration or administration of company. Today, in this session, all these pertinent questions will be answered by none other than our academic consultant for commerce, Sri Kiruch Chandra Maharana. Before he starts deliberation or lecture today, I request all the learners to please switch off their mic, keep their mic in switch off mode. Don't experiment with the buttons like presentation, etc., etc. If you have any question to ask, do put it in the chat box, that will be answered. Or at the end of the lecture, you can ask your questions so that the resource person today, Sri Kiruch Chandra Maharana, will be able to answer your questions. In between the lecture, it is better not to interfere. Let him speak, let him explain the terms, and at the end, we will clarify your doubts, or we can explain once again if any term is not clear to you. Further, while explaining the terms at the end, you can ask also whether he will answer in Odia or Hindi or English. Thank you very much, learners, for making the online classes a successful one. The credit goes to particularly key persons, as we will discuss the key persons of the company. Here, the key persons of the online classes are none other than Honorable Vice Chancellor of Odisha State Open University, who is the visionary of the online classes. Another key person is Dr. Anshuman Jena, who takes great pain in fixing the schedule, and the none other than Rudra and Devasis, who are supporting us like Memorandum of Association and Articles of Association. Okay, now I request AC Maharana, Hirachandra Maharana, my colleague, to start the presentation and deliberation as scheduled for today. Thank you very much, learners. I wish all of you will gain a lot from the lecture of KC Maharana. And MCOMs learners, those who are online today, there will be revision for you, because when you will be attending the class fixed for your MCOM batch, most of the things which will be clarified today by KC Maharana will be again repeated. So you'll be benefited immensely from this lecture also. Thank you very much. All yours, Sri KC Maharana. The stage is
Thank you.
set. The stage is yours. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. First thing I would like to ask all the learners that am I audible clearly to all the learners? Prithviraj sir, am I audible
Yes.
clearly?
Yes. For me, it is very clear, crystal clear.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. So good morning, all the learners. In the previous class, we have studied about the introduction to company, how a company form, and what are the documents, important documents issued by a company. So today we will be discussing about company administration. So how a company is being administered, or how a company is being managed. Clear? So as Prithviraj sir has already told that a company is managed mainly managed by the director of a company. So director can be called as the captain of the ship. Clear? So he is the main key person in running of a company, or smooth flow of work in a company. Clear? So this table of contents, all of you must be able to see. Today we will be covering the director of a company, meaning and definition of a director, or types of director, director identification number, digital signature certificate, legal position of a director, appointment and qualifications of a director, power, duties and liabilities of a director, and we will be also studying other key managerial personals like managing director, full-time director, manager, and a company secretary. Clear? So, first of all, who is a company director? Clear? Who is a company director means directors are the officers of the company who are responsible for managing the company and making the decisions as to operate the company on day-to-day basis. So, this is what a company director is. Clear? So a director must run a company for the benefit of the shareholders. As in the previous class, we have already discussed that shareholders are the real owners of the business. So we must have to satisfy the shareholders. So it is the key responsibility of every director to take decisions to operate the day-to-day business for the benefit of the shareholders. Clear? Then, a company may be a private company or a public company. Clear? So a private company must have at least one director, and a public company must have at least two director. Clear? Then, in the Companies Act 2013, Companies Act 2013, a director is a person appointed to perform the duties and function of a director of a company. It means in accordance with the provisions of the Companies Act, means the duties and the responsibilities of a director has already been prescribed in the Companies Act 2013. Clear? Okay. So here the director is appointed to just to perform all the duties and responsibilities which are prefixed, or which are pre-prescribed. Clear? Which has been already prescribed in the Companies Act 2013. Clear? Okay. So a director, as all of we know, a company has a separate legal entity. So a director acts on behalf of the company and fulfill all the managerial duties. Clear? Okay. Then, along with that, the director takes vital decisions for the company, and there is a board of the directors who can be who can be called as the mirror of a company, or they represents the company, means board of directors represents the company. Okay, then a company cannot exist if it doesn't have a director. Clear? Though the director acts as a captain of the ship, so he is the key person. So a company cannot exist or cannot run if it doesn't have a director. Okay, so here he has to see that all the work being properly managed. Clear? And he has to ensure whatever the company's strategic objectives and plans which are being set, they are actually achieved or not. So we have to analyze that what we had planned and what we are achieving. So we need to always do the variance analysis. So in the company form of organization, the directors actually do the job. Clear? So he has to check all the progress of the employees, also progress of the company towards achieving the targets. Clear? Then objectives are actually set, and the director, the responsibility of the director is to see whether the objectives are being accordingly achieved or not. Clear? So this is the what director is. So director must lawfully and honestly make decision for the benefit of the company. Clear? Then come to next slide. Next slide means types of director. Types of directors means what are the different types of directors which are actually seen in a company. Okay, first is your ordinary director. Ordinary director is otherwise known as general director or a common director. Clear? So a director once joined in a company is an ordinary director. Clear? A director who attends the board meeting of a company and participates in the matter put on the board. So in the board meetings, various crucial decisions, various vital decisions are being taken in the board meeting. So the director is one who attends the board meeting, and he also participates in each and every vital decisions of a company. Okay, so this is all about what ordinary director means. Then come to next type of director, which is managing director. So managing director, as the name suggests, managing director has definitely something more. He has been assigned some with more responsibility than the ordinary director. Clear? So the managing director has a substantial ability. Clear? Substantial ability to make decisions, manage and direct other members of a company. Clear? So he plays a crucial part in the day-to-day management of a company. As he manages as he is a director, so he is termed as the managing director of a company. So here there is one thing that a public company or which is a public company or a company which is a subsidiary of public company, and that that company must have a share capital of more than 5 crores of rupees, must have a managing director. So the company which fulfills the criteria of a share capital of 5 crores or more must appoint a managing director. Clear? And the third type of director is additional directors. Additional director means, as the name suggests, it is a post created to share the responsibility of a director. Clear? Share the responsibility means director has already assigned some responsibility. So an additional director means he just shares the key responsibility of a director. So he is termed as an additional director. So he is like a staff of the company, just to assist the main director. Clear? Any individual can act as an additional director by taking the position of a director until the next annual general meeting. So So regarding our meetings of the company, we will be discussing the details of meeting, what are the types of meeting, or what are the duration between conducting meeting. So in each and every detail, we will be discussing in the next class. Clear? So additional director, again, I am repeating that nothing but he is an addition, or he what? He is a staff of a company to assist the director. Clear? Okay. Then, next is your alternate director. Clear? Alternate director means when a director is absent for more than 3 months. When a director is absent for more than 3 months, an alternate director comes on the board. Clear? On the board on his behalf. Clear? So, if because of any reason the director is unable to come to the board meeting for consecutively 3 months, then the alternate directors come to the board to join on his behalf. So he during this time he acts as an he acts as a director for a temporary period. Clear? So this is what about the alternative directors. Okay. Then the professional director. Professional directors means professional directors are independent directors who are on vocation of serving as corporate directors on one or more boards. Clear? So here what it means, professional directors are actually independent directors who are not a regular director, who are being appointed by the company on vocational basis. Clear? On for the purpose of serving the company. So definitely they will be appointed by the company to take some vital decisions. Clear? So they are not regular directors, they are professionally appointed by the company to act as a professional director. Then next director is nominee director. Nominee director can only be appointed by shareholders or central government, or they may also be appointed by any third parties. Here third party means mostly the third parties with which the company has a dealing, means all the they may be mostly the third party means the creators of the company. So they have the authority to appoint the nominee directors in a company. Clear? So the nominee directors come on the board when there is a grave mismanagement or the board members abuse their powers. Clear? So the nominee directors means they are not they are actually appointed on the need whenever there is a need. So they are appointed by central government or third parties or by the shareholders. Clear? So whenever there is a mismanagement in the company or whenever the board members abuses their power or they misutilize their power, so at that time nominee directors get appointment. Clear? Okay. Then independent director. Independent director means what? Independent directors act as a watchdog in a company. Watchdog in a company means they watch the company from a distance and they observe a company, is everything is going in a right direction or not. So independent directors acts as a guide to the company. Okay, their roles broadly includes improving corporate credibility. Clear? Corporate credibility and governance standards, and playing a vital role in the risk management. So they basically acts as a watchdog. They observe a company whether the company is going in a right direction. Okay, so their roles actually to improve the corporate credibility of a company. Clear? So they also plays a vital roles in the risk management of a company. Then independent director. After that, women director. Women director means Women director. Women director actually in the Previous Companies Act 1956, there was nothing like women director. So the concept has newly been introduced in 2013 Companies Act. So women director means, as the name suggests, a director who is a woman is women director. But there are certain criteria of appointing a women director. So what are the criteria? The company who have their securities listed on the stock exchange and have a paid up capital of 100 crores. Clear? First criteria is the company have a paid up capital of 100 crores, and the company has a turnover of 300 crores or more. Clear? 300 crores or more must have a women director. So the company who passes through, who actually fulfills all the criteria, must appoint a women director. Then small shareholders director. Small shareholders means, so first of all we should know who is a small shareholder. So small shareholders means any shareholder who is holding a nominal value of share to the maximum of 20,000. Clear? So suppose the shareholders hold 10,000 of shares in a particular company. So he is a small shareholder. So the maximum amount must be 20,000 or less. So the nominal value of share held by a shareholder is maximum 20,000 or below that. Clear? So in this case, the small shareholders has the authority to appoint a director also. Clear? So the director elected by these shareholders, clear, will be known as small shareholders director. Okay, so small shareholders directors means director appointed by small shareholders. Okay, so the small shareholders can appoint a director just by issuing a notice to at least 1,000 shareholders or 1/10 of the shareholders, 1/10 of the shareholders, whichever is less. It means what? The small shareholders just issue a notice to 1,000 shareholders or 1/10 of the total shareholders. Clear? Whichever is less, to approve this action. So by giving such notice, the small shareholders can also appoint a director. Clear? The next point is resident director. Clear? Resident director means a director who has lived in India for at least 182 days is a residential director. Okay, means in the complete calendar year, out of 365 days, the director must stay in India for at least 182 days, clear, or more. Okay, so the company called him as a resident director. Clear? The next point is executive or whole time director. Clear? As the name clearly says that, executive director or whole time director. Whole time means full time director who works in the company with his full capacity, or he is a full-time working director of a company. Clear? So they have the higher responsibility towards the organization. So as they devote more time in the company, they must have their responsibility. Their density of responsibility will be definitely be higher in compared to other directors. Clear? So their responsibility, their towards the organization is definitely more in comparison to other directors. Clear? Then the next point is non-executive director. Okay, non-executive director means actually these directors are non-working directors. Clear? Non-working directors and not involved in everyday working of the company. Okay, so this is the opposite of a executive director. Though whole time director or executive director devotes more and more time So they work on full-time basis in a company. So the non-executive directors are not involved in the everyday working of a business. Okay, they might take part in the planning or policy making process. Clear? So they might take a vital decision at times. Clear? Whenever there is necessary, but they will not work as a full-timer. So these are so this is what non-executive director means. Okay. So sometimes actually they challenge other executive directors to come up with the decisions and solutions which are in best interest of the company. Clear? Okay. Then the next slide is director's identification number. Director identification numbers means it is nothing but a 8-digit number. Okay, this is director identification number is otherwise known as DIN number. It is a unique 8-digit number that is allowed by the central government to the individual who intend to become a director or who is already a director in a company. Means a person who is already acting as a director, who is already placed as a director in a company and who wants to be a director, or he or as a director he is going to be posted in your future. Okay, as a director, so he must have a DIN number. DIN means director identification number. Clear? Okay, so now after the Companies Act 2013, DIN number is compulsory for all the directors who are presently acting as a director or who pretends to be a director in the future date of a particular company. So DIN number is very much compulsory. Okay, then how to get this DIN number? How to get this DIN number means it is very simple. Simply, you should go to the website of Ministry of Corporate Affairs. Then, go to the e-filing tab and there download in the section of all the in the download section download the form DIR-3. Okay, it is through the form you can apply for the DIN number. Okay, so nothing is necessary. Your photograph, your identity proof, your proof of residence, and specimen signature duly verified by any authorized person, you can just apply for the DIN number. Clear? Okay, so this is all about director's identification number. Then the next slide is digital signature certificate. Okay, so first of all, I would like to tell that digital signature certificate is nowadays it is a it is what it is necessary for all the directors. Okay, so digital signature certificate or DSC. DSC means what? Whenever we put a signature on a check, means the check is valid. Okay, whenever the signature mismatch in a check, the amount cannot be withdrawn. Clear? So whenever we issue a check by putting the signature, okay, then to whom the signature to whom the check is issued, he will get the money. So why the bank is allowing the transaction through checks? Okay, the signature is valid. The signature he bank actually matches the signature. So the digital signature certificate means it is just like a signature. Clear? In the slide we you all can see that there is a what a pen drive like a pen drive like device. Okay, so digital signature certificate means it is just like a pen drive. And in the when we what insert the pen drive in a system, so there is a two security pin. Clear? So in the pin by giving the security password or pin, it is authorized that this person has duly signed in a particular document. So the pen drive the pen drive actually contains various useful data regarding the person. This is a proof of identity. Clear? Okay, so in what place the in what place the DSC used? DSC can be used. So it can be used in e-filing of Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Okay, it can be used in limited liability company registration. It can be used in returning of income, returning of GST file. Clear? So okay, so in these fields actually DSC used, digital signature certificates used. Then from whom actually DSC, we can get DSC from whom actually? So it is actually issued by the certified authority. Certified authority, so whom actually certifies the whom actually certifies Ministry of Electronics and Information and Technology. So there are various certified authorities in India, such as eMudra, NSDL, Capricorn. So these are the certified agencies or certified authority by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology to issue digital signature certificate. Clear? Whenever we are applying for DSC, it takes maximum 3 to 7 days to which is very much compulsory for all the directors. Okay, then next slide is legal position of a director. Clear? So what is the position of a director? What is the legal position a director director held in a company, director hold in a company? So director as an agent. Clear? Agent means director are the agents of the company in the eyes of law. Okay, as we know that company cannot act its own, company cannot act or cannot work as its own. So it can only work through director. Clear? So director here can be called as an agent of a company. The next point is director as trustees. Trustees means directors are the trustees of the company's money or property. Clear? One second.
Yes, Kirud, you are not audible. What happened?
No, sir. Nothing. Yes, sir. So the next point is directors as trustees. Trustees means directors will take care of the fund of the company's money or property, which is actually under the control of the director, and they are responsible for proper use of that fund. Clear? So beside this, they are the trustees of the power entrusted to him for applying the fund to the company. Applying of fund means where the fund will be applied or where to use the fund. So they takes the decision. It's a very crucial decision regarding the funds management of a company. So directors they are actually authorized to use the money or the properties of a company. So directors can be called as a trustee of the companies also. Then the next point is directors as officers. Okay, directors as officers of a company means director shall always be treated as officer of a company. Clear? Some case, if the director wants to be an employee of the company, okay, he can be an employee, but directors holds a very high position, he is always be treated as an officer of a company. Clear? He may or may not be an employee of the company also. Clear? Then the next point is directors as employees. Directors and as employees means when a director is also in the service of a company means such as manager, as accountant, as secretary or otherwise. Clear? He will be treated as an employee of the organization. Clear? As an employee of the organization, he is also entitled to for remuneration and other benefits as an employee in addition to the rights of a director. It means whenever a director acts as an employee, will receive all the benefits. He will receive all the benefits and also entitled to remuneration for his service rendered as an employee. Clear? So though he is also a director, so he cannot be deprived of all the rights of a director. He enjoys all the rights of a director of a company also. Clear? So he can enjoy, he will be given all, he will be given what? He will be given all the benefits like an employee, and he is also enjoys all the rights of a company director. And the next point is directors as a managing partner. Okay, managing partner means as the director manages the business, as the director manages the day-to-day affairs of a business, they can be a managing partner. So here actually the law of agency applies means like a partnership forms of organization, law of agency applies. Okay, so partners can act both as a principal or and as an agent of a company, because and also partners can bind the other partners by their act. Okay, so this is the agency, this is the law of agency says. So in the company, no authority to bind other director like a partnership firm. This is the main difference between a company's managing director and a partnership firm. So directors can be also treated as managing partners of a company. Okay. Then appointment of a director. What are the criteria a director must have, a person must have to be appointed in a company as a director? Clear? Okay. Usually what happens, the director appointed by a company by the shareholders mainly, but whenever a company starts, what happened, the promoters usually appoint the directors. So after a while, this duty is done by the shareholders. Clear? Okay. So a company as an artificial legal personality can appoint a director by shareholders mainly. Okay. So what are the criteria? The person must be a real person. Okay. So in the slideshow also you all can see that appointment of directors by the articles regards first director, means before the shareholders, the promoters, or it is also mentioned in the articles for the appointment of first directors. Then the company at the general meeting. In the general meeting also directors can be appointed. Okay, by the principle of proportional representation. This is a crucial point. Principles of proportional representation means the majority of voting of the shareholders. So here the shareholders are authorized with some extra power. They can even vote per share per director. Okay, so this actually happens. Per share per director means it is called principle of proportional representation. So the shareholders can vote for the director on majority basis. Clear? So by the board also there can be appointment of directors by the third parties, then by the central governments, and by the small shareholders, as we have already discussed about all the how a small shareholders can appoint a director. Okay, so by the tribunal in the Sikh industry. Sikh industries means this industry which is not running or not functioning in a profitable way, or the industry which is struggling to function. Okay, struggling for smooth flow of work, or struggling to execute its operational activities. So in that case, the tribunal or the court of law has the authority to appoint the director. Okay, then the next slide is qualifications of a director. qualifications of a director means what are the qualifications? Is the slide is visible? Qualifications of director? Hello, hello.
Yes, sir. Visible, visible.
अच्छा क्वालिफिकेशंस ऑफ डायरेक्टर स्लाइड देखा होची तो
हां सर विजिबल सर स्लाइड विजिबल सर
अच्छा ओके ओके एक्चुअली आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क द स्टूडेंट्स इज इंग्लिश टू इंग्लिश इज व्हाट दे आर कंफर्टेबल और आई वुड एक्सप्लेन इट हिंदी और सम अदर लैंग्वेज Okay. Then the qualifications of director. As regards to the qualifications of director, there is no direct provisions in the Companies Act 2013. Okay. But according to the different provisions relating to the directors, the following qualifications must be mentioned. Okay. Following qualifications means what are those qualifications? First is a director must be a person of sound mind. Sound minds means he must be a normal person. He should not be a person of unsound mind or imbalanced mind. Okay. The next is director must hold a share qualification. Share qualification, if the articles permits, if the articles of association permit, share qualification means a director's must hold some shares in a company. Okay. Then the next is a director must be an individual. Okay. Directors must be a solvent person. Solvent person means personally he should be a solvent person or he should not be a bankrupt. Okay. So he can be a director of a company. Then the director should not be convicted in a court of law. Clear? He if he is convicted by the court, then he cannot be a director in a company. Okay. Then disqualification of a director. Okay. Disqualification of a director. Okay. So, like qualifications of a director, there are disqualification of a director also. So, disqualification means the criteria which restrict a person to be a director in a company. Because, like a person of unsound mind, a person who is unable to pay his debt, okay, or he should not be declared as insolvent, okay, or he when a director has been sentenced to imprisonment for at least last 6 months for the offense that involves morally wicked behavior and 5 years have not passed from the date of expiry of the sentence. If the director is sentenced to imprisonment, then after 5 years, that only he can apply for a director of a company. Within that, he will be disqualified to be a director in a company. Okay. Then the next slide is removal of director. So what are the criteria where the director can be removed from a company? Okay. The director can be removed either by the shareholders or by the tribunal. Okay. Either by the shareholders or by tribunal. So in case of shareholder, the shareholders has the power to remove the director. Clear? So it is done by section 169 empowers that the company to empowers the shareholders to remove a director in a general meeting just by passing an ordinary resolution. Okay, so by passing an ordinary resolution, the shareholders has the power to remove the director of a company. Clear? But in case the director is appointed by the tribunal, clear? If the director is what? If the director is appointed by the court of law, then the shareholders has no right to remove the director. If the tribunal has appointed him, the tribunal has only reserved the right to remove the director. Clear? Then by the tribunal means there are certain cases where the shareholders cannot remove the director. The director can only be removed by the tribunal. So on the application to the tribunal for the mismanagement by the director, when the director mismanages a company, so he can be removed by or he may be terminated by the tribunal also. Clear? So on such termination, or there is another condition, that on such termination the director cannot serve the company in a managerial capacity for a period of 5 years from the date of order of termination. Whenever the tribunal orders the director to be removed from the company, or when the tribunal orders the director to for the removal of the company, the director cannot manage the company in the managerial capacity. Clear? For the time of 5 years from the date of order of termination. Clear? So this is all about removal of director. Clear? Then the next slide is resignation of director. Resignation of director means director may resign by giving notice in writing to the company and board of directors. Clear? Director, if he wants to resign from the company, he can just give a notice in writing to the company board that he is going to resign from with effect from this date. Clear? He has to also forward the copy of resignation to the registrar of company. Okay, and he also, in the copy of registration, he has to mention what are the exact reason of his resignation. Clear? All this has to be submitted to the registrar of company. In the resignation letter also, the date is clear, the date should be clearly mentioned from what which will be the effective date of resignation by the director. Clear? The director shall be liable also after his resignation for any offenses which occurred during his tenure. Clear? After the director resigns, he is also liable for all the offenses. He is also liable for all the offenses during his tenure. Okay. So if he has done something wrong, or something like mismanagement of a company, or something unusual sort of thing, then he is also liable even after his resignation also. Clear? Okay. Resignation of director. Then the next is powers of a director. Powers of a director means general powers. 179 subsection 3, powers matters. Clear? So in the section 179 of the previous Companies Act 1956, it actually empowers the board, clear, to exercise all such powers and to do all acts and things if the company is authorized to do so. Clear? So when directors acting malafide, clear? Malafide means if any director has done any act which is ultra vires to the company, then the directors can be removed by the shareholders. Clear? Then board incompetent. If the board is incapable or incompetent, then, and there is no legally constituted board, clear, then the shareholders also exercise their power on the directors. Clear? So the deadlock in the board means what? When the administration of a company is standstill or it stops, so then deadlock of the board. So here also the shareholders have the inherent power to take necessary steps. Clear? Then power under section 179(3). So these are actually, I am briefly reading it out to make what are the powers under section 179 subsection 3. Okay. To borrow money, to invest fund, to grant loans, to issue securities, okay, to authorize the buyback of shares, and others. So power under rule 8. Rule 8 means here the directors has also the power under the rule 8 to make political contribution, to appoint and remove any key managerial personnel, to approve any annual financial statements, to review or change the term and conditions of public deposit. Okay, so these are mainly powers of the director. Then the most important, what is duties of director? Duties of directors are actually fiduciary duties, duties of care and skill, duty to attend board meeting, duty not to delegate, duty to disclose interest, statutory duties, and duties to prepare director's responsibility statement. Okay, then fiduciary duty, what does it mean? A director must exercise the power in good faith, okay, and for it should be the benefit of the company as a whole. Okay, so the director should distinguish the personal interest and the company's interest. So he should protect differentiate between his personal interest as well as he should protect the interest of the company. Okay, the next duty is duty of care and skill. Okay, the director must perform his duties with reasonable care and skill. He shall be liable for any negligence on his duty. Okay, so he should be very much careful and dedicated to the company. The third duty is duty to attend board meeting. Okay, the director has the director should attend every board meeting, or what he may he try to attend the maximum board meeting. Okay, so it is, however, it is not compulsory for all the director to attend all the board meetings. So he should always try to attend maximum board meeting. Okay, if three consecutive meetings or continuous three period of 3 months he will be absent, then
not audible.
Hello, 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 sir. Sir, sir, some I think sir, am I audible?
Yes, right.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Okay, 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 sir. I think the next the connection was disturbed, I think. Okay, the next is duty to delegate. Duty to delegate means, as a rule, the director must perform their duty personally and should not delegate their office. So director should only delegate their duties if the act of the articles specifically authorized them to delegate his duty. Okay, so it is upon the articles of association whether it permits the directors to delegate his duty or not. Clear? Then duty to disclose interest. Okay, as all of we know, the director as an agent of a company, so he should always take care and see that his interest and duties does not conflict, does not what it his interest and duties does not conflict or does not contradict. Clear? Okay, so these are the main duties of a director. Clear? Then come to the liabilities of a director. Liabilities mean to what extent the director is liable to the company. Clear? If he commit any unlawful sort of things, then he should be liable to the company. So the liabilities of a director, he is broadly divided into two parts, such as civil liability and criminal liability. Okay, so again, civil liability is of two types, such as towards the civil liability towards the company, and civil liability towards the third party. So civil liability of towards the company means negligence. If the director neglect some things, so he will be liable to the company. So the director must exercise diligence in performance of his duties. Whenever unable to manage the company's affair, he will be liable to the company. Okay, then misfeasance. Misfeasance means this is more than a negligence. More than a negligence means it is what? Breach of duty on affairs of the company, which causes loss to the company. Loss to the company means it is not merely mere negligence, it is more than a negligence. Means whenever by the act of the director, the company suffer from loss. Clear? So this is called as misfeasance. Then breach of trust, as all of you know. Then ultra vires act. Ultra vires act also we have already covered in last class. Ultra vires act means anything that beyond the capability of a director. Clear? Any act which excess the power. Okay. So in this case, the director is personally liable to the company. Clear? Then criminal liability. Criminal liability means, as per the Companies Act 2013, certain duties upon the directors and certain duties upon the director, and they are personally liable to penalties either by way of fine or even by way of imprisonment. Okay, if they fail to perform them. Clear? So some of the examples of criminal liability I would like to say: filing the prospectus containing untrue statement. Untrue statement means if there is anything which misguide the shareholders and which already mentioned in the prospectus, then the directors will be criminally liable to the company. Okay, then while inviting deposit against the rules of conditions. Okay, against the rules of conditions means whenever a director is inviting the public to offering the public to invest in the company, so whether it is it should be as per rules and regulations also. Clear? If he violates the director is criminally liable. Clear? Okay, so in this case also a maximum of 25 lakhs of fine and maximum 7 years of imprisonment is they can be imprisonment also they can they will have to bear. Okay, then issuing false advertisement. Okay, then failure to repay excess application money. Okay, excess application money means while issuing shares, the amount of share which are going to allot. Okay, there may be some oversubscription also at that time. The duty of the director to return the excess application money received in the process of allotment. So if he fails, then he will be criminally liable to shareholders. Clear? So these are all the criminal liabilities. Then other key managerial personnel means director can be called as a key director can also be called as a key managerial personnel because he is the most vital person in a company. So we have studied the director separately. Clear? Apart from director, there are also many key managerial personnel. Key managerial personnel are those who are actually those people having authority and responsibility for planning, directing, controlling the activities of a company. Clear? So key managerial personnel means they do all the managerial functions of a business concern. Clear? So in the key managerial persons, there are actually we have included managing director or chief executive officer, managers. Okay, so in their absence, the whole time directors also act as a key managerial personnel. So the next point is company secretary, and the third one is chief finance officer. Clear? First chief managing director. Managing director we have already discussed in the in this class. So now actually chief executive officer. Clear? Chief executive officer or managing director. Clear? So he is responsible for running the whole company. Okay, as the managing director has all the authority of operations. Clear? All the authority of operations, he has the most powerful man in the managerial hierarchy. So in the managerial hierarchy, managing directors holds the most powerful position. Clear? He is also responsible for innovating and growth of a company at a large scale. Clear? Okay, in many countries, or even in India also, the director who is managing or who holds the highest position in managing, sometimes called as chief executive officer, or what we call CEO of a company. Clear? Then we come to the company secretaries. Company secretary is also a senior level employee in a company who is responsible after the efficient administration of a company. Okay. The company secretary takes care of all the compliances with statutory and regulatory requirements. Okay. He also ensures that the target and instruction of the board are successfully carried out or not. Clear? Okay. Then come to whole time director. Whole time director, as all of you know, that whole time directors is a what? Full time directors who devotes maximum time. Clear? Maximum times or maximum working hours in a company. He is different from independent director. Clear? So as he has a significant stake in the company. Clear? Independent directors doesn't have any stake in the company, or doesn't have any share of the company, but the whole time director holds a stake in the company. This is the difference between what a whole time director as and a independent director. Okay. Then come to chief financial officer. Chief financial officer means, as the name suggests, he controls all the financial activity. He holds the top position in the hierarchy of finance. Okay, so he we called as CFO also. So it is a senior level executive actually who is responsible for handling the financial status of a business. So it is a very crucial and very vital position of any company, because it relates to finance, it relates to fund, it relates to money, or from when the funds will raised, from where the funds will invest, will be applied, or when the where the funds will be invested. So CFO holds a vital role in any company. Clear? CFO what he does, financial planning, he does the financial planning, he operates the cash flow. Okay, he creates the contingency plan, or contingency plans mean any keeping of provisions, reserves, and etc., many things. Okay, so he must have a contingency plan for possible financial crisis. So when the situation arises that or a company is going through a financial crisis, then the company, then there is every possibility that the company will be close down. So in that condition, the chief financial officer plays a very important role in the company. So he always creates contingency and for any crisis which will arise in a future date. So these are the key managerial personnel. So these is all about today's class. And we actually learned about the directors, their key positions, their liabilities, their duties, their powers, types of directors, and apart from directors, what are the other key managerial personnel? Who is a whole time director, who is a chief financial officer, who is a company secretary, who is a managing director. Clear? So this is all about today's class. So may I request Mr. Prithviraj sir to say something or to conclude the class, and if there is some questions, then we will discuss here also.
Yes, thank you, Kirod. Questions, I'm not coming across any question. Any learner, if he would like to ask any question, that he's allowed to ask. If no
any learners,
please.
Any learner who have any questions, you are free to ask.
One senior most learner is there, Mr. Abhishek ji. Unka bhi agar kuch questions hai, to puch sakte hain.
No, I think.
Well, it appears there is no question from the learners. I must thank you. Kirod, for the nice presentation.
Thank you,
the
sir.
number of students were few. I do not know the reasons for less participation, but if they know and they are not participating, then they are losing an opportunity. Because in the pandemic situation, we have no other alternative except going for online classes, and they have to depend on online classes. If any problem is there, they should go through their study and learning materials, SLMs. They should study, and they can question. The WhatsApp group is formed also, particularly become an MCOM students. They can ask their queries or questions through the WhatsApp also. Secondly, certain things that in case of women director, two things are there. First off, all the listed companies, it is mandatory for all the listed companies to have women director. Who is a listed company? Any company who has listed in the stock exchange or offering their shares to the public, they are duty bound to appoint one women director. And from October 2014, it is compulsory. At the time of incorporation, you should name the women director. Secondly, in case of unlisted companies, the criteria is either your turnover or your paid up capital, 300 or 100 respectively. Second, trust. Trust is utmost good faith or uberima fidei, we call it. Utmost good faith means it is not yours, but you should treat and behave as if it is yours. I have handed over my car to you for safe custody. I am going somewhere else. That means I have relied on you, and that you should take care of my car. Though the car is not yours, you should take care as if it is your car. That is a simple example of good faith. Any violation is breach of trust. Okay, tort law. Then your misfinance or malfinance or non-finance, there are different things. Misfinance is your intention. In all these terms, misfinance, malfinance, and non-finance, intention is important. Your intention is good, but during the course of exercising your rightful authority, you have hurt someone or you caused loss to someone. That is a civil case and called misfinance. You will be penalized for that. Malfeasance is intentionally you have done that. It may be criminal breach of trust. These are the things. Anyway, so many concepts have been beautifully explained, and I hope things are clear. Then one point needs elaboration: professional director.
Yes.
Because you have come across the thing that there is no set of qualifications are prescribed for to become the director of a company. A anguta chap can be a director. No harm in it. Can be a director. There is no prescribed qualifications for a director. But we hire or take into board professional directors to share their experience and knowledge in the day-to-day administration of the company. Okay, so they are known as professional directors. Certain things cannot be done by everybody. It needs a separate knowledge. If somebody has acquired that knowledge, then he should be inducted as a director. Suppose the government decides to or a group of people decides to float a company, hospital, a private hospital, but it will be a public company. So, sir, invited, everything is okay. Now, if the promoters and directors will be non-medical persons purely, do you think can that particular company or hospital be managed properly? No, certainly no. So, they need to induct people who have medical background or experience in medicines or whatever it is as professional directors. Professional directors are inducted for smooth running of the company. Okay, I have this much to share with all of you, but a big thank you to KC Maharana, who has taken all
thank
the
you, time sir.
To elaborate the things and beautifully covered. Time management was well. Only point of concern is that less number of learners are coming. We have to look into the matter. What are the reasons for less participation? I assure you, that as you have discussed, I have already discussed with Dr. Jena to ensure that at least 24 hours before, 24 hours before, learners will get the intimation of the class as well as the link. Hope in the next class also, we'll expect the cooperation from KC Maharana as well as from the learners. Also, I must thank Rudra Babu and Dabasis Babu for their support and the work they have done behind the screen and acting as the bridge between the learners and the resource person. Thank you very much. Thank you once again. Expecting to see you soon. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Devasis Babu.
Sir, Kondu.
Sir, ticket link pothe debe mote.
Google Drive
रहली सर
आ गया सर ओके नमस्कार।